course first, because...
Oh, I guess you guys probably knew that, though, since I told Jake we're doing the...
Yeah.
Well, it's our party.
Yeah, I think you've told them our plans several times.
I'm just too excited. I love Hollywood Studios. I know it's a little bare bones right now, but yeah. Still has some of my favorite rides.
And before we came here, Taylor and I marathon watched kind of all of the Star Wars movies because she had never seen them before. So now. She's totally up to date on all of the stories, and we're going to ride Star Tours 100 times till we see all the stories that there are.
I know, I have BB-8 on my shirt and everything. I'd show you, but it's cold on this bus.
I'm not going to complain about the AC, because you all out in internet land, unless you live in Florida, don't know this right now, but I can swim in the air outside. It's so humid.
It's pretty cloudy, though.
Yeah, so that's helping.
Number nine,
Taylor. Try the Wookiee Burger, Taylor.
It's so funny, I can't see anything.
You gotta try the Wookiee Burger. It's to grrrr for. Good effort. Yeah, I'm not good at it either. Sorry, internet, that you had to deal with that. Tire. Taylor!
What?
Taylor, it's a tire.
It's a quartet. Is he gonna wait in line with me?
Yeah, I guess. We could play the game where I run away and you try to find me. Okay. Bitch is about to get randomly selected.
It's way too hot to do that. I'm already
sweaty. All right, let's go get a beverage.
Have a great day.
Thank you. Hollywood Studios. Oh my God. So...
I already have to pee.
It's the excitement pee, I understand. Hi, dinosaur. Hi.
Gertie.
Huh?
Gertie.
It's Gertie.
You know, there's very few things I hate more. Than looking like a moron because you can't get the sink to turn on.
Oh, trying to conjure the water out of the faucet, yeah. Star Tours!
So excited.
Going on a magical Star Wars adventure today! How excited are you for your first Star Tours where you know what's going on?
I'm pretty excited. I don't think I'm going to be an expert by any means, but...
I have faith in you.
Do you?
Yeah.
Okay. Happy anniversary, thank you.
Yeah.
Paging Star Tours passenger Mott Warren. Please pick up Vineyard's white courtesy comm link. Passenger Mott Warren to the nearest white.
Just trying out my new small talk program. Seems to be working. Honestly, I don't know how you humans do.
Continue to move all the way across your aisle, filling in at every available seat.
All right, we're gonna go in. See you on the other side. What do you think?
Very entertaining. Like the story plot is basically like. Well, it's from the new Star Wars movie where you're like racing through. Whatever the hell planet that was.
I forget what planet she is from.
Yeah. No, it would have been Tatooine.
Was it?
Same one that Anakin was.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, that was really rough though. Like, I'm actually a little.
A little queasy.
A little queasy from it.
See, I am not.
Wow.
Which I'm surprised.
Well, you took Dramamine, I
did. I did take Dramamine.
Or whatever.
I get motion sickness pretty severely, so.
Yeah, still very entertaining, though. 5 stars, we'll do again.
I think we will later.
Great.
Walk the street, right here. Just set it down right here. Okay? How's that? See? Now you're blocked. Yes, very nice. Now where is Miss Desmond? Betty, where is Miss
Dorman Esmond? I don't know. She's pretty old. She could be dead.
You're right. She's not a young woman. I heard that when she was growing up, rainbows were still in black and white. I gotta shoot this scene. And this is really unorthodox.
But I'm a Presbyterian.
No. It's unusual is what I mean. Would you please stand in for Miss Nesman and shoot the final scene of this motion picture?
Me? Me? Betty Campbell's Brandenburg, Michigan Fools, Ovarian, and me in your movie?
Do you think you can do it, kid?
Me? Betty Shambles? I could watch them all day. It's nice that the there's a lot of clouds.
Yeah, because like that 36, the sun was out, I sweated every drank so far.
Yeah. We can head to Tower of Terror now if you are interested.
Yeah. Our fast pass started at 11:45, so we got an hour. It's 11:50 now.
Yeah.
I think, you know, being that it's 300 meters away, we could probably make it in that time. What do you think?
I'm just saying, like, do you want to do that now?
Yeah, I was acting for the people, Taylor. I was sharing how the system worked with them organically.
Dumb.
It's good.
Do you like Tower of Terror?
I love Tower of Terror.
I do too. I'm so excited.
There's nothing I love more than having my stomach impact my jaw after I've had my stomach impact my jaw.
True story. It's a long line.
Yeah. Nobody cleans it.
Holy crap, we are right back.
They need to hire me. It's really dirty.
Oh, yeah.
You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, things and ideas you just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
Thank you.
I'm C-3PO, human cyborg relations, and this is my counterpart, R2-D2. I am fluent in over 6 billion forms of communication.
See far, far away.
It was cool to like see the characters.
Yeah.
But like it was, then the explosions were cool. But other than that, it was like pretty lame.
Pick a direction. Where are you walking? Okay, walk that way. I have to agree because I kind of felt like, I guess Disney,
like
Disney
retelling.
Might, yeah, Disney might still be trying to figure out how to Star Wars.
I think so.
I think that might be what's going on. Like
the
everybody's
movie was
just
really good, but like how to present it in a.
Yeah. I think everybody's just, at this point, amped to be able to see the characters they love in real life, and that's good enough. Now we're gonna do the great movie ride, because there's only a 20-minute wait.
Yeah, we're gonna go on the great movie ride.
Yeah.
It's actually only a 10-minute wait.
Oh, nice. It was a 20-minute wait when we got in, well, not in line, but when we went to go see the show, the Star Wars show, and then in the, what, 10, 15 minutes we were standing there, it went to like a 10-minute wait, so.
Yeah, we have a late lunch reservation today because I didn't know what time we'd be getting to the park. I didn't want to miss it. So I did a late lunch reservation, and we're going to get pretty, everything but Rock and Roller Coaster done before lunch, so.
Look at us go.
That's really nice.
That being said, there's only like
five things to do here, but.
Not that big of an accomplishment, but yeah. Okay.
So actually, just a 3-minute wait. We got in really fast. Yellow brick toad. What'd you think, Jake? You like the great movie ride?
Yeah, that was it. It's a longer ride, and of course it's air conditioned, so it's like, I mean, practically walking onto it helped too, but it's a good ride to like sit and relax a little bit, because there's nothing like jaw-droppingly exciting about it. It's just a nice ride to be entertained by for.
I like the great movie ride, yeah. It's a good, like, yeah, I don't know, it's just fun.
Yeah, it's a good one. Like, we've been very close to getting a card several times.
So, for those of you that...
So, for those of you that don't know,
as soon as you use your third scheduled fast pass, when you're in line for that ride, you can go on My Disney Experience and get another fast pass. And you can keep doing that after you use all of your last fast passes for that day.
Right. Roger.
So I'm on right now looking for another fast pass because this is our third.
We've run through three fast passes. It is 1:20 in the afternoon.
Let's see. Rock and Roller Coaster. What time is that? Do you think 3:45 for Rock and Roller Coaster is
that should be plenty.
Awesome? Alright, I'm going to get that one then.
Yeah. Because, I mean, with that, all that means is that you pretty much... To get the most out of your day, you should schedule your fast passes early in the morning so that you can knock them out and then go and get other ones just throughout the whole rest of the day. Just keep getting fast passes.
We're not going to film the ride because I'm going to beat him.
Yeah, she's actually pretty good. What do you think it's going to be?
I'm just going to go Woody.
I'm going to go Bo Peep.
Bo Peep just passed, you lose.
Wow. That was quick.
Oh no.
Oh, Wheezy. We got a broken one.
Oh! The greatest comeback in the history of the world!
Wow, those are pretty high scores though.
For us!
My arm hurts.
I know.
I don't know how you pulled ahead at the end. You got double the amount of points out there.
Did I?
Yeah.
At the end?
Yeah, that just in that last screen.
Yeah, I don't know. I must have just been more. I think my accuracy was a little better than yours.
Yeah. So what are you doing now, Taylor?
We are waiting to go to lunch at the Sci-Fi Dine-In.
Playing the waiting game.
I'm looking at our reservations because I couldn't remember what time we had to be at the Star Wars dessert party tonight.
Right.
That's at 6:30.
Super amped. So fun fact, if you come to the Sci-Fi Dine-In, they have popcorn. You can just take some. It's free.
I like this little touch. The, like, speakers.
Oh, yeah, just like at a drive-in.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so cool. So what'd you order?
I ordered the shrimp pasta and a vanilla milkshake, and I'm going to have... warm glazed donuts for dessert.
Holy
this is
going to
be
crap.
So much food.
Yeah, this is going to be really, really
I'm not
good.
Used to this.
And it's 1,000 degrees outside.
Yeah, we eat very light usually, so well, hopefully we can make Indiana Jones after this and just sit down for a while when we're done.
Yeah, because I got the Oreo milkshake and the New York strip steak, and probably going to have whatever their candy bar thing is, the house-made sci-fi candy bar, which is... white and dark chocolate mousse layered with crispy pearls sandwiched between sponge cake. Oh, and dipped in chocolate ganache.
So, I'm so excited. I'm so hungry.
This is gonna be heavy. I'm gonna sweat it all out.
Yeah.
Starting with milkshakes.
I got Oreo.
I got vanilla. And big glasses of water.
Oh, it's a cherry. Okay.
No, it's a little dark, but Jake got... what is it? The steak?
Yeah, New York strip steak.
New York strip steak with onion rings.
I believe there's cheesy potatoes as well.
Yeah, there's. It looks like there's carrots and
there's
beans.
Veggies underneath it.
And I got shrimp pasta. Really excited. Here we go. This is Jake's sci-fi candy bar. And this is my cinnamon donuts.
They both have pearls.
I know, I'm so excited.
So that's exciting.
So we are gonna dig in and we will tell you what we thought about Sci-Fi Dine-In when we are done.
And Taylor, review of Sci-Fi's Diners and Drives with Guy Fieri.
Sci-Fi Dine-In. It was really good. I'm really full.
Yeah.
The milkshake was good. It was really thick. So it was like super hard to drink until the end.
Yeah.
Until it melted a little bit.
Yeah.
The pasta was good. It was spicier than I expected. It had a little bit of kick, but the shrimp were really, really good. I didn't eat all of it because it was too much. And the dessert was awesome. I got the donuts and, oh, it was apples and a crispy donut with vanilla ice cream on top. Would recommend, 10 out of 10. My Amazon review would get again.
Yeah, you like that kind of thing though. I mean, you like the donuts with the cinnamon and the...
Yeah, if you guys don't know, I am not a chocolate eater, so...
Oh, yeah. I, on the other hand, definitely am. So I, basically because we got the dining plan for free, my plan with eating for this entire dining plan thing is just get the most expensive thing on the menu so that I can be...
Why don't I record you?
So anyway, like I was saying, because we got like the dining plan for free, my plan for basically the entire time we're here with us eating is like just order whatever the most expensive thing on the menu is, because any entree is included. It's not like they make you pick and choose from the cheaper things. So like I had a $32 New York strip steak, came with like cheese, potatoes, and onion rings and veggies. You got a milkshake with that and dessert. It's all part of the whole thing. Our final bill was like
91.
Been like 91 and change.
Yeah.
And
without a tip.
Without tip. And, you know, we basically got it for tip. So it's the way to do it.
So we are going to head over to Indiana Jones, let our stomach settle before our next fast pass at 3:45. It is 3 o'clock right now, so it actually works out perfectly. Just watch some Indiana Jones and chill, you know?
Yeah, Indiana Jones and chill. I'm real glad that we, like, did Star Tours and Tower of Terror before we ate.
Me too.
So if I had to go do that now.
Barf everywhere. So we'll catch up to you in Star Wars. Nope, Indiana Jones. Where are we going?
Same music, guy.
Yeah, all right. Here, bye.
Baby in front of me.
Okay.
I was telling her how to Disney.
Okay.